Her five-minute monologue alone is the most watched of all the plays, with 2.5 million views. She's now made a sequel, as our arts correspondent Polly McLean reports.
She's been doing stand-up for 25 years and entertaining us in lockdown with her comic voiceovers, including her rambunctious renditions of the First Minister's press briefings.
Right, look after each other, you know the rules. Take care. Frank, get the door!
But when Jenny Godley was invited to join Alan Cumming, Brian Cox and a host of others in making short performances for the National Theatre of Scotland, she decided it was time to get serious.
I thought it would just be too easy to do something funny. I do funny videos every day. I thought it would just be too easy. And I wanted to tackle a subject that would be really hard to get across and contain quite a lot of nuance, and a sausage dog.
It's hard in lockdown. I mean, I'm not alone. Got my wee Doug.
In Alone, she plays Betty, who's struggling with lockdown and a controlling husband. And it seems to have struck a chord with viewers. It's the most watched film in the season. 2.5 million people have seen it since it first aired in May.
Couldn't believe that the one thing I wrote was the one thing that kind of tapped into everybody. I'm really proud. Don't get me wrong, I'm not being like, oh, how me. I'm really proud that the writing that I've done and the acting that I've done has got recognition. It's wonderful. I mean, I never thought for a minute a wee bird for the East End of Glasgow would be working with the National Theatre.
And so many people got in touch to ask what Betty did next, Jenny decided it was time for a sequel.
You can come down now, Mum.
This time, she's not alone. She's joined by her son, played by Scots actor Jack Loudon.
If I'd have done a wee play about Betty and Jim at the Tron, you would no guarantee that the people would come and see it. But because we've done this online, I love that so many people are just... intrigued. People keep writing to me privately going, tell me what happened. And I'm like, you have to wait until Wednesday and then you'll find out what happened.